All right, so the physical level of the LR Goku event just dropped, and I want to go over a couple things. First off, I want to go over the intelligence team building just because I want to make sure that you all had it, you were aware of different team formations that you could use, since you can now use any droppable character in the game for it. So I'm going to really keep this video very, very short, as short as I possibly can, for the sake of you guys having the ability to know exactly what you need to use. I personally prefer King Vegeta and Lord Chilled together. They hit off three of each other's attack links, which are Bombardment, Thirst for Conquest, and Super Strike. So right off the bat, they're inherently getting 50% attack buff just by being together. The way I like to run the event is I like to have a King Vegeta on one side and then a Lord Chilled on the other as my double leader. So that way I get the HP and attack buff and I get the ki buff. So at that point, you would want to bring the Fruit of the Tree of Might so that way you get enough ki to get actual super attacks off. From there, I also like to have on opposite rotation Ice Shenron with the GT Super Saiyan Trunks. Because they give each other, even though that's not really needed too much, they give each other 3 ki. So they're always going to be hitting off super attacks because Trunks' passive is going to be ki plus 3 for all intelligence types. I believe he also gives it a defense buff. But with that, you'll always be supering with them too. I guess you could supposedly also run the other Super Saiyan Trunks since he is formable and droppable. And you could have them together. It'll be Super Saiyan Royal Lineage if you're using the Fruit of the Tree of Might. That way they're going to give each other one extra key, so they're going to be getting 4 key just to start off with, and then you can rely on your floaters for the additional key, or the Fruit of the Tree of Might. Now, one thing that I do want to state about the Fruit of the Tree of Might, I don't recommend using it until you're going up against the final round Goku, just because you don't want to, you know, be in the last stage of the last bar of health. When he's hitting his hardest, the third stage is when he hits the hardest. It goes easy, medium, then hard, at least that's the way I see it. So I prefer to use all my items towards the end, except for maybe a Sensu Bean if you need it, then towards the beginning. But I like these pairings myself personally. These guys will always be getting super attacks. Also, you want to make sure when you use the Fruit of the Tree of Might, it would only be with these two. That way you get them 2 times. Overall, after that, then you can choose who you want on rotation. You can either choose this Trunks for rotation, but he only really links well. I mean, he does link well with both rotations. You just throw King Vegeta in the middle. And that would be cool. And then you also have the Super Saiyan Trunks. So he hit off with both of them. That's how I try to figure it out anyway. Nappa, I do like having him on the field only because he does have that super rare chance to go Great Ape. It's not viable, you shouldn't be banking on it, but I did utilize him and he did go Great Ape for me about 2 times, so that's cool. I did enjoy that, but remember, it's just that's RNG based, so don't bank on that. The other one is going to be Korra. He's not the greatest in the world. I don't really like him too much, but he does share some common links. And I also like this Frieza. The rest of these guys are kind of just, well, these two are just throwaways. I don't really like using them at all. He will hit hard, this Golden Frieza. He has an attack buff. This is the one that the Mecha Frieza tokens from. He has an attack buff plus 42%, so he will hit a little bit harder. But he doesn't really fit too well just because he doesn't really link well with anyone. I do like this Android 16, but because you can now use all droppable characters, you don't really need to rely on him taking hits. So overall, I like these four over here. A King Vegeta, Lord Chilled, and then you're going to bring Lord Chilled with you, so you're going to have 2 Lord Chilleds technically. And then I like having these two guys over on rotation, or you can swap out that Nappa with this with the final form Frieza that you get from his event. But the next one is we're going to talk about the strength building one. Now the strength building one's a little bit different because there's a lot of different, a lot more different droppable characters. Personally, I like to run the LR Frieza, though I don't have him, so I use his TUR version. Now I like keeping these two together just because they have Metamorphosis. That's a 5% HP recovery, and they also share the common link skill Big Bad Bosses. So when HP is 80% or below, they give each other a 25% attack buff and defense buff. On rotation, on the other rotation, I like to have Grandpa Gohan and this kid Gohan. They hit off 4 of each other's link skills, which is really freaking useful. It's All in the Family, which is a defense buff, Turtle School, which is 500 attack, Credible Adventure, which is ki plus 2, and God into the Dragon Balls, which is attack plus 20%. So they're really giving each other a lot of attack, defense, and ki all together. Remember, you're going to be running a Grandpa Gohan lead, so he's going to be there. Might as well bring a character that links very well with him. And you're going to have a Grandpa Gohan friend, so when he's on rotation, he'll at least be getting that Goku buff as well. Those two work very, very well together. Remember, his new leader skill is ki plus 3 HP attack and defense plus 20%. So overall, it's very, very useful, very viable. If you do not have LR Frieza or any of his variants, though at this point I think you should, because it's just, even if you have his SSR form, these two would link very well with each other. If you don't have this Goku to bring with this Grandpa Gohan, another two that are really good with linking each other is the Super Saiyan Trunks and Vegeta. They're not the most optimal, they're not the best overall, but they give each other 2 key between Golden Warrior and Royal Lineage and a 10% Super Saiyan attack buff, so that's pretty cool. Now, in the middle is usually where I keep all of the ones that have decent link skills to be on rotation, on floater. Remember, you already have a Grandpa Gohan, so you can only pick two more. I like this Goku right here. Personally, he'd be my number one pick if you have him. This was from the One Piece crossover event. I have mine, Super Attack 10. I would recommend bringing him. He hits off Boo's Kamehameha, which gives him an attack plus 2500, and these two as well, so that's awesome. If you are running these two on rotation because you don't have this Goku, then he will hit off their Super Saiyan links. That's very viable. He actually hits off, what, Golden Warrior and Super Saiyan? And then for Vegeta, he hits off Golden Warrior, Saiyan Warrior Race, and Super Saiyan. So he's very, very good for linking with them. The next one would probably... See, it's difficult to say because there's not a lot of cards that link well with LR Frieza and Buhan. So you're going to have to hit or miss with that. I like GT's Rildo. He's pretty cool. He lowers attack. This Pan from GT is pretty good too because she shares some common link skills with Gohan and Grandpa Gohan and Goku, all in the family, and I believe it's Kamehameha, the Innocence, 10%. So overall, you do have some decent choices. Tao does have a chance to stun, so he's cool, and he links with Grandpa Gohan pretty well. Again, there's not a lot of cards that link with all of them. So if you were running these two, this Vegeta might come into play for you, but he's just more of link skill buff. He doesn't really do that much. But yeah, guys, that's it. I'd recommend this. That's who I would recommend running on your strength teams is the LR Frieza and the Majin Buu Gohan Absorb, the farmable one, along with Grandpa Gohan and the kid. If not, you could always grind out Vegeta with the Trunks because they link very well together. The One Piece Goku is definitely someone who I would recommend if you have him to put on that team just because he's a decent card to have. And over here, this is a lot easier to follow because it's smaller. So go ahead, rewatch that if you want to go over the intelligence one again. But anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today. I hope that was helpful. I hope that was informative. Hit that sub button if you're new, and I'll catch you guys later.